Good. Now, yeah, it is 2:30 perfectly. Good. So thank you so much for keeping the presentations like on time. That is so important. And thank you, Venkatesh, again. And now we have Praveenkumar Hulakund.
Yes.
From Oracle. And he'll be talking about the improved eventlogging in MySQL 8.0.
Thank you. Yes, my name is Praveenkumar Hulakund. I am working as Principal Software Engineer in MySQL team, Oracle. I am with Oracle from more than 6 years now, and I'm part of MySQL runtime team, mostly contributed to the transactional data dictionary and to new error logging and other interesting features in runtime as server-side statement timeout. And today I'm talking about improved error logging in MySQL 8.0. Yes, this is our safe harbor statement. As part of this presentation, we'll look at introduction to error log and motivation for error log change in MySQL 8.0, and about improved error log, some of the error log components, and new rule-based error log filter, and at the end, some of the important changes done to the error log in MySQL 8.0. Okay. The MySQL error log contains a record of MySQL startup and shutdown time. Here is an example of MySQL server startup message with the timestamp and the version of the server we are using with the process ID. And this is the error message reported for server shutdown time with the timestamp. And MySQL error log contains diagnostic messages which are reported during server startup or during server shutdown and while server is running. And these messages are labeled with the severity of the error message, that is error, warning, or note. Here are the examples about error messages which are reported while server is starting the server with the note and a warning severity one. And on some of the servers, on some of the platforms, even the call stack is logged into the error message if server is aborted, exited abnormally. And historically, we supported logging to only error log stream and to the file. This is a system variable which is used to configure the error log output to log error stream out to the file. And later we supported logging to the Windows event log and to the Unix system log. And MySQL also supports filtering of the error messages based on the severity of the error message. And this is a system variable used to filter the error message, and default value for this prior to 8.0 is 3, which means all the error messages with the labels error, warning, or note are logged to the error file. And other valid values for this system variable is 1 and 2. If it is set to 1, only error messages are logged to the error file. And if it is set to 2, error and warning messages are logged to the error destination. So this is a brief introduction about the error log content, and the filtering of error messages. As I mentioned, historically we supported logging to only file and log error stream. Then we supported logging to the Windows event log and then to the Unix system log. And with each new logging format, the server code is changed. And to support new logging format, say to log in the JSON format or to the XML format, we need to change the server code. Because of the same reason, even customer cannot have their own logging format. If customer needs new logging format, then the server code needs to be changed. And as I mentioned, currently log filtering is supported only at the severity level. MySQL does not support filtering error log messages on the other parameters as error message or a subsystem which is reporting the error and other parameters. And we can rate limit some of the error messages. That is, in some situations, same error message is reported in the given or in the particular window time. We can rate limit such error messages, but to make such changes, we have to change the source code, which cannot be done by the DB or the user at this point of time. Okay, to address these issues, the error messages or error logging is improved in the MySQL 8.0. New logging format without changing the server code, the logging is made as loadable in MySQL 8.0, and it is implemented using the MySQL component framework. And a component can implement services which are defined by the logging subsystem, and it can load and log the message in the format required. The service which can be implemented for logging are of two types. One is filter and the sync. Sync is a log writer which writes to the error destination, and filter is the error a component which filters the message. Here is an example of components which are loaded to the server. This block is the internal block which is always available. This is called as built-in components. These are always available in the MySQL server code. This can be enabled by using one of the system variable which I am going to explain in the next slide. And if user wants logging in some other format, then the component should be loaded and enabled. Or these are some of the components which are already there in server, or user can write their own logging component, load it using install component statement, and write the error log messages. Error logging subsystem internally builds error log stack, that is to pass the log error message to the log components installed, and these are enabled by adding to the system variable log error services. This by default log error service has these two components, that is sync internal and filter internal. This writes to the traditional error log file. Filter internal is used to filter the error message by severity mode, which we discussed in the second slide. Log error services, the user can add the components to the log error services in the order he wants to do, but it should be separated by the semicolon. As mentioned here, the order of components in the log error service is very important. By default, as I said, log error services has these two components, which has a filter internal as the first component and the sync internal as the second component. So in the stack, sync internal is loaded first and then the filter internal is loaded then the filter internal is loaded. So when error message comes, it is filtered by filter internal component and then returned to the writer component. This is the overall picture of logging from the MySQL code. Before we had a very simple error logging statement which has the information about only a severity and the error messages. Now a new C++ API or C++ class is introduced, where more detailed information of error message can be logged. I will talk about this API in the next slide. Log event class or the object generates a log event line for each of the information supplied to the log event. A log item is created, that is a key value paired log item, which contains a key. In this example, it's a timestamp and the actual value and the log item priority. This log event line is example for the shutdown message, which also has the log message with the message information. And this log event line is passed to the log error stack. So depending upon the order or the components registered to the log subsystem, the log event line is passed to that component. For example, suppose we are only using the built-in services, built-in components, then this line is passed to the filter internal first. And if we have a rule, a log error verbosity set to filter the error message, then it is dropped at this component only. And the error message doesn't satisfy the condition specified in the log error verbosity system variable. It is passed to the sync internal, which writes to the log error file in the format as timestamp, severity, and the error message. This is the complete APIs of the log event C++ class, where we can now specify the error code of the error message. Before, we used to mention only the severity and the error message in the server code only. Now all the error messages are moved to the error message dot text. So for each of the error message, the error code is generated in the server code, and we can specify the server symbol, OS error number, error message, source file where the error message is generated, source line, even the function name, subsystem. We can specify that the error is generated in the server or in the replication or in the InnoDB module. And we can specify the component if error message is generated at the component, in the component code. And we can specify other informations as user, host, thread ID, priority, and the label. Message, as I mentioned, if your error code is mentioned, then message is generated from the error message.txt file. If not, user can pass the error message, and verbatim is where we don't use the formatter for the text error messages. We can just pass the string, and the timestamp are the values which we can pass with this function. In the code, we have wrappers for this class right now, that is log error and log plugin error. Now we are using these APIs to log the error message. MySQL 8.0 has some of the error log components already in the code. As mentioned, this is sync internal. This is a traditional error logger, which logs to that server log file. This is in the built-in components list, so this need not have to be loaded. And we have log sync JSON. This is a new component introduced in 8.0. This writes log message to the log destination in the JSON format. And the URN to install the component logs, this component is component log sync JSON. And it writes error log messages in the error log file.json with the JSON extension. This component is used to log the error messages to the either Windows event log or to the Unix system log. If user wants to log to these Windows or Unix system, Windows event log or Unix system log, then this component should be loaded. These are the filter components introduced. These are filter components introduced in 8.0. This is part of the built-in components which filters error messages on the log error verbosity system variable value. And 8.0 introduces new filtering mechanisms, that is rule-based filtering mechanism. We'll see about this in the next slide. So these are the few components which are implemented in the MySQL 8.0. So this is the new filter, that is rule-based filter, and it is a if-else condition-based, if-else-based language, where user can specify the condition on any of the field. Field is the key in the log item, which we saw in the previous slide. And he can add a binary comparator. He can compare it with the value or the Boolean comparator with the exist or not exist of the key, and write a action for the condition, that is either drop the whole log event or rate limit the log event. This is called as throttle. We have the example in the next slide about it. And we can change some of the keys in the log event, or you can remove some of the fields if not required from the log event. And this is each rule is terminated by full stop in this full stop, and the rule should be set to the system variable log error filter rules. So these are few examples about the filtering. The first example is to drop the log event with the priority of information, and to remove the source line field from the log event itself. So here is a rule set with the log error filter rules. If priority is greater than equals to information, then drop the whole event, log event. And in the log event, if source line is mentioned, then unset, then that log item is removed from the log event. And this rule is this example is to rate limit the events which are of information type, and it will be logged only once in 60 seconds window. Here is the rule for it. If priority is equals to information, then throttle just log only one error message in 60 seconds window. And this example is to change log item value, that is error symbol. Here is the rule for it. If error symbol is equals to error startup, then change the value to error s. So these are some examples about rule based filtering. So these are some of the changes which are done as part of MySQL 8.0. By default now, as I mentioned, in the 8.0, by default all the error messages, all the severities are logged. So it is changed to 2 now. Only warning and error messages are logged to the error destination. And if we see the error log, there are many error messages which are not actually error messages, are just information. For example, server startup message or server shutdown messages, which were logged as the note or information in the 5.7. So in 8.0, a new severity or the label is added to such messages or such system messages. Now it is such messages are logged with the system label, and these cannot be filtered as they are not the error log messages. And all the error messages have the unique error message ID now. So if user wants to filter based on the error message ID, he can use the error message ID for those. So if we see this example, this is about the startup message. Now this startup message has the new label as system. And for this error message, this is the new unique error ID. And this is logged by the subsystem server. And the other message format remains the same. And second example is about, so do you have any questions?
He will leave it to Q&A session. Okay.
And this is the example of another message, which is a warning actually. So it is logged with the warning and the unique error message ID and the error message. So that's all. These are some reference about the error log and the error log components and about the filtering. That's it. Any questions?
Yeah. I'm wondering, did you get feedback from the field with regards to, as a result of the new granularity, did you get more or less error messages coming out? The reason I'm asking that is back in the good old days when we had message pagers, whenever there's an error message, your message pager will go off. If you're a field engineer, and the worst part of it is government tenders are not written by human beings. What you get is this really barbaric clause that says that if an error goes off, you have to resolve it within 1 hour. The thing is, by the time you get back to your desk, it's 1 hour already, especially if it's on the weekend or after hours.
This will not change or increase or reduce the frequency of the error messages. It is just the way the error message is logged and the format we want to use it, format in which we want to log the message.
Right, but the thing is, a lot of so-called error messages are actually cry wolf.
You want to check the similarity of the error message?
Uh-huh.
So we have three different types of similarity. One is note, one is warning, and then you have the error.
No, you will get the same severity. It depends on the engine that is being used to alert.
Yeah, so the application needs to sort of, like, you got a signal only if it is an error, because that's the only crucial thing. But in case it's just a note, it's something that, it's just note, you know, make a note of it. If it's a warning, it's something probably you can look at it in some time. But if it's an error, that's where probably it needs to be alerted. I think that's the problem with probably the application that gets.
Is there automatic action that
they can? Right now we don't have, but if the user or the developer wants to change the component, I mentioned about the component which is either a filter or a writer component, log writer component, they can write application logic which takes the error messages, sees the type of the or severity of the error messages and generate the warning or notification for that.
It's a third party product.
It's not part of the product, so, yep.
I am throwing that.
Any other questions?
Any other questions?
Okay.
You work in MySQL?
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Praveenkumar.